love with a dope boy. Till she found out. Dope boys, bitch ass niggas. Scared of the killers. Scared of the riders.
Tracy T, MMG, baby, what's happening? This shit started. But this radio station gonna go in right quick, you dig?
When I did to that pussy boy, you damn right I hit up. You damn right I hit up. She heard I was a dope boy. She heard I was a dope boy. I heard she was a gold digger. I heard she was a gold digger. All I know is she a real bitch. Oh, she a real bitch. Fuck her like a real nigga. Man, they in Miami, I was fucking.
Miami's Party Station, Power 96. Your boy Casey Chops, as promised. We have something special happening in the city tonight. I know you other DJs, you hating DJs, are nauseous right now. It's going to be some serious, serious things happening. I got Ricky Rozay in the building. How you feeling, my brother?
You already know. What's happening, homie? I see you on flame out here.
Out here, man. Tracy T.
Yo, what's happening?
New signing from Atlanta. How you feeling, man?
I'm feeling great. What's happening?
And we got Fat Trel, DC Zone.
What's up?
How you feeling, man?
I'm good. And yourself?
Man, I'm still in recovery mode from Liv last night. Khaled's birthday, Rozay. I don't know if you...
You know, Khaled usually had the craziest birthday parties of the year.
Yo, he got like
bring everybody out, all the sexy ladies, all the young G's, all the OGs. It usually be one of those events.
He had to have gotten like $500,000 worth of performances last night, man. It wasn't
that's
a game.
Usually how it goes.
Yeah. And that champagne hangover is a different type of hangover, man. So you know.
But that's anyway, a beautiful thing.
Talk about Man, we got something special. These new signees right here. I call you, the first time I interviewed you, I gave you the AKA Ricky Riley. Because you're doing these major pickups.
I like that.
And this was, you know, right when you brought in Meek and Wale. So now we're here again.
Yeah.
Talk about these two young men right here, man.
Man, you know, it's just all about the energy. You know what I'm saying? As far as artists, you know, that you bring into the fold. You know what I'm saying? Especially when the bar raised so high. It's really about the energy. And you know what you're going to bring to the table as artists. You know what I'm saying? And, and these two individuals that's right here, Tracy T to the left. Of course, Fat Trel. We keep saying these names because we just want everybody to get familiar as soon as possible.
Yes,
sir. These are two young dudes that won't be denied. You know what I'm saying? It's that same hunger I seen in myself, that I seen in Meek, that I seen in Wale. You know what I'm saying? And it's a beautiful thing. And them boys going to do their thing, you know?
Tracy T. They played your joint at Liv last night too, and it kind of rang off.
Yeah, 16.
Yeah, Meek Mill.
Believe that.
Started with a 16.
Going crazy.
Tell me how that record came about, bro.
Man, you know, it just come about with working, man. You know, we was working. Mm-hmm. Crazy beat. Beat Big, you never produced it. Mm-hmm. You know, and I just did my part. You know what I'm saying? Went crazy on the track.
Talk about that Atlanta scene right now, bro. You're one of the new cats from the ATL.
Most
definitely. About to blast off.
Most definitely. Out of Atlanta, man. The East Side, man. You know. I've been rapping for a minute.
So what's something you want to bring to MMG?
Great energy, man, and that Southern, that A-Town, the whole A-Town swag, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
And plenty of energy, you know?
So you're bubbling right now. You got like a mixtape you're going to drop? Anything, what are we looking at?
Most definitely, mixtape coming real soon. Okay. Coming real soon.
Okay, Fat Trel, DC's own man. How you feeling? You went right to the Ciroc.
Yeah, this is what I do. I don't play no games with my situations.
Right.
How you?
I'm good, man. Talk about this new record. I could hear the DC in you because you sound Southern, but you sound like you have up top influences as well. Uh-huh. You like in that border to me based off the single I heard.
Okay, yeah.
How did that come about, man?
The single came about just me in the studio. And, I was just going through my email like I do any session that I got by myself. Mm-hmm. And, I just found the beat. And, that specific night, shout out to Izzy, the producer. He produced a record. Mm-hmm. That specific night, I just felt like working on that. And, you know, the vibe, I usually let the instrumental give me my feeling or the topic of discussion. Mm-hmm. Like, I want to speak on. And the beat just brought me, she fell in love with a murderer vibe. And that's how the record came
about. Yeah, beat's one of those goosebump beats, man. It has soul into it. And
crazy.
Yeah. Shout out to Izzy, the producer, man. He put that situation together for me.
What's up. Rozay, man, talk about this tour. You just came off it, your first live tour with the 1500 or Nothing band.
My first live tour, shout out to 1500 or Nothing. It was just really for me, you know, just mm-hmm. being, you know, going into my 6LP, taking it to that next level. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? What I could do to go to that next level. Mm-hmm. And it was really just, you know, bringing that live feeling to the records we make. And, you know, we went on the first leg of it. You know, we already putting the second leg together. first leg was highly successful. Mm-hmm. We sold out, you know, majority of the nights, the tour sold out. But it just felt good to see the people come out, support like? Rozay, you know what I'm saying, on my Tux vibe. You
okay,
know what I'm
why
saying?
Not? Yeah. Talk about that live feel, man. When you got a band behind you, it's got to be a different game, you know?
It is. It's most definitely a different game. I thought a lot of times, you know, coming up, because I really didn't understand the live sound. A lot of times I used to feel that bands took away from those street anthems. Gotcha. You know, but, you know, I was really looking for a band. I had been to New Orleans. I had been to Chi-Town. I had been so many different places. Mm-hmm. And when I ran across those dudes, they took
me. I first heard of 1500 or Nothing on an old game track with Just Blaze. And they just went, it was like a 9-minute record. In the last 4 minutes, they just went ham. Like,
oh, that's crazy. Yeah. That's crazy.
The album date, did it get pushed back? I'm hearing rumors. I don't know. What's the official date?
Well, we haven't released the official date. You know, we still putting minor details on the LP. You know, I had just got in the studio with, you know, a few people that, you know, I just had to make sure as far as the details. One was Bobby Womack, you know, and, some other things I was doing. So, I haven't chose the date, but most definitely we got a few more details we got to do. So.
so everything's good with you and Def Jam, though.
Yeah. Def Jam. Shout out to Def Jam, man. That's the label that, you know, put me on the platform, man, and most definitely gave me all these resources. And, you know, we on top now. So salute Def Jam. Double M is coming.
That's what's up, man. I want to congratulate you on this whole MMZ thing. The way you flip it on the paparazzi, I don't think no one's ever done it like that. You use their game against themselves. Like,
right.
Like talk about that, man. Like, you, man, because there's dudes that mess up when it comes to that, man. Talk about that. How it came about, first of all. Like,
you know, it's just me being a person that's always been in the media, mm-hmm. You know, for so long and for different reasons, for positive things, for negative things. I just come to find out and realize a lot of times, you know, you shouldn't take, you know, a lot of this stuff as serious as you think it is. Because, you know, in real life, you know, real people have real things going on in their real life. So, you know, a lot of that little petty things that you see really cracking, it ain't even nothing really cracking. You know what I'm saying? So I just began to really you look here.
Okay.
You know, and it just, you know, it was just becoming a fun thing. So, you know, shout out to everybody that, you know, do they thing, though.
When's the next episode dropping to that, though?
Man, you know, they ain't running up on me like they used to, man. You know what I'm saying? They ain't running up on me, you know, like they used to. But it's all good, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. This Wingstop thing, man, I think, first of all, there's an aroma lingering through the room right now, that lemon pepper aroma.
Oh, man, it's that lemon pepper vibe.
It's got me in a zone right now.
Yeah, shout out to Wingstop. Wingstop is most definitely in the building, you know what I mean?
These things are popping up on every block, man. What's the deal with this? When's the, are we looking at new spots?
Man, we got a new spot that's under construction right now. Well, you know, I'm right here from Kara City. We right in the middle of, you know, we 5 minutes from Miami Gardens, you know, where I'm from, and County Line Road. My barber used to, the barber shop right next to that was in the same plaza as Machico's. Okay. You know, we used to go through there and wait for the barber. And, you know, I tried that Wingstop and that lemon pepper a long time ago, and I was just like, whoa, when I get right, I'm going to put one of them in the crib. You know what I'm saying? Okay. And I was joking with the homies, and, man, I ended up buying one. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the business was all good, so we had to do the double up.
Okay.
Then we had to triple up.
Expanded.
Go to that next, you know what I mean? Yeah. And so on and so forth.
You got, what state you got them in? You got them in Florida?
Yeah, we got them in Florida. We got them in Tennessee. We got them in Tennessee as well as Jackson.
Okay.
It's just a different little spot, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Yeah,
Cali, you got grinding. Them out in Cali?
Yeah, we grinding.
Okay. Speaking about the crib, you always showing love to dudes. Like, I'm so happy you did that, gave K-Cutter that look.
Yeah,
you know, you rep for Iceberg.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And shout out to last night at Live, Sam Sneak. He got on set, and this might be the first time I've ever heard Miami music come out of those Live speakers, because those DJs usually aren't from here.
Wow, that's
and,
crazy.
And you know, it melt, man. He was playing old Trick Daddy, and to hear that in Live, you don't really hear that. You know what I mean?
Man, you know, that's crazy, and that's what Sam Sneak all about. He most definitely all about the crib. And you know the funny thing about Sam Sneak is we had a little club that used to be at the El Palacio on Wednesday nights. It used to be a little MVP.
Woo!
Yeah. MVP at El Palacio. And Sam Sneak, this was years ago. He was 14. I don't even know how he got in the venue. And he walked up on me this years before I got on and gave me a CD, told me he was a DJ. So I stayed in touch with him ever since then. And when we wrapped up the first leg of the tour, I just thought about that. Salute the little homie. He always repping Dane County.
That's what's up, man. And I saw on World Star you was in Dubai.
Yeah.
I've heard that place is like, it's like going to the future.
Yeah, it's most definitely a rich spot.
You got any crazy stories or
man,
something?
Man, it was a lot of beautiful women over there. Dubai's,
yeah.
You know, the people, you know what I'm saying? It's a lot of energy. Everywhere you go really don't show you that southern hospitality everywhere you go, but Dubai most definitely.
So they weren't looking at you crazy? They don't look at foreigners crazy because we're not dressed like them?
No. We came in, you know what I'm saying? They knew what it was, but it was one particular chick that when we was walking out of the club, you know, she asked for a hug, and I gave her a hug, and, you know, we kept moving our way, and it's like she just ditched her boyfriend and ran with us, caught up with us and ran with us.
The thirst is real.
Yeah. And, you know, the dude ran behind her, and it was finna get ugly, and, you know, and like I told the dude, I was like, you know, I apologize, but she chose me, fam.
Man. You need MMZ for those things, man.
That's what I need.
Yeah.
Shout out to Dre,
fam. Okay, I'm hearing this No Games remix is you getting ready to launch that soon?
Yeah, No Games remix. You know, we finna pop that off ASAP. Shout out to Meek Mill. Shout out to Wale. It's a Double MG thing.
Okay.
Yeah, real big. 2014, finna be a real big year. Double MG, myself, Wale. Meek Mill albums all coming, Double MG.
Okay. I seen a tweet, Lady Gaga tweeted that you were going to be on her remix.
Shout out to Lady Gaga, the one
that's
only.
True?
It's most definitely true.
Not a lot of rappers can pull that off, Ross.
Man, that's big, man. You know, and the genius about it is, you know, she recognized my genius and she reached out and, man, we did that. And so I can't wait for it to touch down. Whoa, 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 whoa. Got it all off a bag. Started with a 16, teen, nigga. Now I got 100 P's, nigga. Migo came and dropped the ton. Ton, bitch. Made the profit, gave it to my mom.